my name is Hashim Mohamed, I'm 36 years old, I'm Italian by nationality and 7 years resident in Ghana. I hold my first degree in economics and law, master's in economics and management of urban development, and currently attracting my PhD in industrial development. I'm the founder and CEO of Green Effect of Business Leaders Limited. Green Effect is a new generation of environmentally friendly, community oriented, and knowledge driven cluster of commercialized business of CDIs that have been modeled to the vision of ensuring that we become the global leader in ecological business and impact investment. Our mission really is to transform the world's social, economic, and environmental attitudes into measurable social, economic, and environmental profits through innovation, seeding production, and industrial leadership. Greenup was actually established in response to the business opportunities created by the uniquely challenging conditions of the Gobi Savannah and political zone of Ghana, an area that covers about 65 and above the 10 to total land area of Ghana, home to some 10 million people, about 70% of whom actually live in rural areas. What are the challenges of this area for which we have found a number of business opportunities? This includes increasing the rural poverty, environmental degradation, high levels of structural out-migration by the youth as a result of high unemployment, the social establishment. Established 10 million hectares of land, the problem of the minority of the political zone are very poor in soil structure, soil organic matter content, soil water content capacity, and soil acid nutrients to their level. So, well, as the company, what we have done is that after about 3 to 5 years of extensive research, experimentation, and international laboratory analysis, we have established and found the Kenaf plant, which our Kenaf is known as scientifically as hibiscus cannabis. So we have found the Kenaf plant as one of the panacea to the problem of the Northern Savannah ecological zone. So what we did in 2014 was to conduct a project that we described as Kenaf Zero Waste Characterization Project. The overall goal of the project was to establish 100% digitalization of the Kenaf plant from its leaf to the seed, the fiber, and to the top for the production of a whole range of products that are out here. So from the leaf, we are able to find very highly nutritious, edible vegetables for human consumption, very high in food protein. And also from the seed, which we have here, we are able to extract highly edible oil from the seed. This is actually edible oil for human consumption. And also after the extraction of oil, the seed residue is also good for light short seeds. Then from the fiber, that we have all known, this is the fiber of the Kenaf plant. What we have is that after the rigorous working process, we are able to make jute packs here for profit. We are also able to jute packs actually for storage of most agricultural products like cocoa, nice grain, groundnuts. Then we are also able to make this environmentally friendly shopping bag from it. The objective of this environmentally friendly carrier bag is actually to weed out the pollen ethylene carrier bag problem, which we have indicated as poor sanitation at the new office. Then from the top of the plant, we are able to briquette it into a fuel wood. This will get in partnership with RUF briquetting systems in Germany. And then also, pyrolyzing the top of the plant, we are able to make biochar. I think we know what the biochar is. Biochar is the carbon that has been pyrolyzed in the low oxygen environment. And this is why it's used as a soil amendment agent. So for the standard zone, the 10 billion hectares that are poor in soil structure, we want to improve the soil resistance with that. Then also with the charcoal briquette, I mean, a lot of the cost of conditions in the area, I mean, the people about 70% live in rural areas, the source of fuel relying on the natural vegetation to burn charcoal and carbon. So what have we done? We have actually done this product, but the challenge is that we do not have the resources to be able to conduct the necessary scientific analysis, register this product, certify them, produce them in the good quantities that we need, to be able to take them to the market and to do the market research so that will establish the consumer preferences for the product, prices of the product, product specification, and the quantities that are required and the right quality levels of the product. What we have done is that we are now looking for funding to actually do all the necessary product analysis, we produce into the product development, product analysis, certification, and certificate of market research. A preliminary market or demand for the product is that we have established over 10 million consumers from institutional marketplace for both of these product lines that we have talked about. For example, the juice tax, the Ghana Cocoa Watch imports large quantities of things, and also other clear users also use it to package agricultural produce. And then also from the meat, food and vegetables, and also the edible oil, we also have established a market across the Ghana School Feeding Program. We have a number of senior high schools that actually need the oil and also the meat for feeding the children. Also, we have a number of partners with whom we are working on this project. Locally, we are working with the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research and the Savannah Agricultural Research Institute. We are working with this partner to do a lot of the analysis of the product. And then also Carbon Carriage GMB from Germany, Agri-Air Application System. We are also working with a number of the, we have for the juice tax, we have the Limited Impact PVC Limited from India. They are specialists in the manufacturing of juice milk, that can find a lot of this. In terms of impact, what we are actually looking at is looking at creating huge numbers of employment for the unemployed youth of the community of the zone who are actually migrating out of the area instead of opportunities are you have instead of the higher years, the non employed young girls migrate to the staff and get a million jobs at high risk. And we have a very dedicated team of young professionals actually supported by a very qualified and dedicated board of directors who actually guide us in terms of implementation of our Kenyan railway standardization project. So we look forward to being supported to this funding. Thank you very much.